the things which are required with the teachers. It is not just your educational technology or innovative temperament to be true. Suppose you attend this workshop and after that you cannot speak up. So both the things are required: your communication skills, your knowledge, your technical and professional competence, and your understanding, your consideration sense, and your collaboration also. Now, what I'm this is the thing that I just wanted to show you in the presentation. Like pedagogy, you people know, andragogy and heutagogy. So andragogy is teaching adult learners, pedagogy is teaching the teenagers. We people don't have teenagers in the universities. We have got adult learners who are capable, who have got resources with them, and they people can also search the things themselves. And the third thing is called heutagogy, in which we just facilitate the learner. If the people get stuck somewhere, then we provide them help. Otherwise, that is related to self-learning. That is the Eklavyaism, I can say. The heutagogy is in which we just guide them. We do not instruct them. In andragogy, we do instruct them, but we customize our material according to the learners who are adult learners, not children. Pedagogy is, of course, which goes in an instructive way. This is what we people have been doing. So we'll move on to what I'm going to do with this thing now is I'm going to give you a quiz because so many people are worried about how quizzes will work. So let me share with you the quiz thing. And what I'll do, I'm going to display the quizzes screen for you, and you will be able to see how this thing about quizzes is coming to you. Now, can you people see I've just shared the screen of my Google Chrome, and it is just reaching you. You will be able to see that. Now, can you see Google Chrome now? Now, Google Chrome, I have opened a website which relates to quizzes. So if you people have installed the application, now quizzes has been installed. Please open the app. I'm giving you a game code, everyone. And the game code can be, I guess you people might be happy. Like everybody has been watching Ramayana and Mahabharata these days, and Shaktiman also. So I'm taking it as Ramayana and Shaktiman quiz. There are 10 questions only, and I believe everybody can see the screen also. The code is there on the screen of our conferencing, and the code that I have sent you is 321180. I request Principal Ma'am, you and a few of your observers and anyone, you people can keep an eye on the screen that I am sharing rather than playing the game so that you can see how it is working. Now, Deepak ji, Krishna Kumar, Komal, Rashika, Vidushi Deekshit, 3211. Kisi ne code hi dal diya hai. Someone has entered the code and put up name. Preeti Kumari, Shubham, Jaya. Then what we have is me, Tanushree, Amit Singh. These are the people who have joined it. Now, when you people have installed quizzes, it is an application in which a game code is required. So what I'm doing is I'm giving you the game code. The game code is 321180. There are 18 participants only, and we have got a big number that way. We have got more people here. So if some more people can join, we can start it. Chandruji, welcome. And if I feel okay, Vandana Sonkar is also there. There are 20 participants, 21. That's good. Neeta Singh ji, another participant. 23 participants are there. You can keep an eye on the screen also that I have. Shikha Rai has joined. Now these are 24 participants. What you are doing, everyone is using the link. The code which has been sent, it is possible for me, like those who are not using it, the faculty members who are not having the app, they can go to the link which has just been shared through the chat, joinmyquiz.com. You can go to joinmyquiz.com. There also you can enter this code. If you do not have the app, then you can go to joinmyquiz, enter the game code. Okay, 25, 26. Those who are still downloading, go to Google Chrome, click this joinmyquiz.com link and play it there. Not a problem. The app is not required to play. So what you can do is you can, good, Krishnakant Singh ji, Dr. Alok Goel, there are 29 people now, and you can see it on my screen how many people have joined. I wish that the number reaches 35 at least, so that if you are not able to install it, you can still keep an eye how it is going to work. Now there are 34, and the moment I'll get 35, I'm going to start the game. And what is going to come here on your screen, everybody is going to see it themselves. My screen will be displaying the scoreboard, the results that way, and your screen will be displaying you questions, and between questions you will be getting the score also, whether your rank is going high or not. You will also be able to see your points. The other thing that you will be able to see in the application interface is that, if you people remember the Kaun Banega Crorepati lifelines, you will also be getting some lifelines in the beginning. They call them power ups. The power ups, like you can erase a wrong answer, you can freeze the time, like you can give a wrong reply but your score will not go down. You can double the points, like you say that I'm going to answer a question and I claim double points, rather than 100 I play, I'm going to ask for 200. Fine. So am I allowed to start now? I'm just looking at the chat if someone is still saying okay. Buffering, 35 done. What we'll do, we'll play the quiz again at the end of the session. We are playing it now also, so that those who are going to miss it, those who are missing playing it, they can keep an eye on the session's screen from my side, how the score is displayed, and other people are going to play it. So here we go.
Please wait. Sir, please wait.
Started, sir. You can join late also, not a problem. Please remember, those who have the code, they can join late also, not a problem. Stop the music, that way you can keep on playing. We are keeping an eye. You are able to see.
करना क्या है सर?
मैं आपके पास कोड आ जो आया है 321180. आप गेम कोड में उसको डालिए. एक गेम
मैंने डाला है आपके साथ, गेम में है आपके साथ.
हाँ, आप खेल खेल रहे हैं.
इसमें लिसन एंड सेलेक्ट द नेक्स्ट लाइन. या ये अवतार नहीं है, इंसान है, शक्तिमान शक्तिमान.
तो आप उस पर टच करेंगे ना, क्विज खेल रहे हैं आप. मैं इसका आंसर बताऊं आपको?
हाँ, एक मैं जान लूंगी तो फिर आगे.
हाँ, और ध्यान रखिएगा, सब लोगों के क्वेश्चन शफल होके आ रहे हैं. मतलब अगर ये लाइव क्लास होती, इफ यू पीपल वुड हैव बीन सिटिंग टुगेदर इन अ क्लास, द क्वेश्चंस एंड द इवन देयर ऑप्शंस, दे शफल.
सर, लिसन एंड सेलेक्ट द नेक्स्ट वन.
Okay, you can mute your audio also, because it's not the same for everyone. This soundtrack can be played in the class when you people have got smart boards and there is a sound system also. This scoreboard, which is displayed from my side, can also will be displayed by the teacher, and every student will be playing this game either through quizzes.com/join or joinmyquiz.com. Both the websites take you to a place where you only enter the code which is given to you. The teacher can enable that only those who have an account with on quizzes, they can play. Otherwise, to play a game, you may not need to make an account. Good. Shubham ji has done it pretty well. 7830. But Shubham Agarwal has reached on the top now. Amit Singh is 6680, rank 3. Nidhi, rank 4. Vineet George is on 5. Komal is on 6. And Vandana Sonkar is on 7. But the interesting thing, everyone, is 66% accuracy. It means these 10 questions are being felt like tough questions. And my screen can also display which question is dangerous. Question number 7. 7 is listen and select the next line. Here, people, 20 incorrect options have come and 7 correct options have come. Another question which has been tough for you, I can tell you, that is Sita Swayamvar ki shart kya thi? Those who do not know Hindi, they people can just play the English based game, and the purpose of adding Hindi is to make our teachers confident that you can write in Hindi. You can also write in Punjabi. The same way you can write in your regional languages also. If you can type in Microsoft Word, if you can type in WhatsApp in your own language, which is your native language, so you can just use those tools that you use to type your language, your own language, the native word. So let me go back to the leaderboard. 67% accuracy, everyone. Okay, there are some more people. There are a few people like Chandruji, Deepika ji, and Yash ji, and Dr. Deepika as well. You haven't been able to start. Certain times there is a 10 questions were there. Certain times there is a possibility that because of your Wi-Fi or because of the firewall issues, it may get stuck. But most of the times it works properly. Suppose in the class when it is being played live, I see that there is someone who's creating trouble. So I see that there is a student with the name Me. And the rank is 39, everyone, and I request this fellow teacher not to mind it. I found that there is someone who should not be there in the game. I simply go and cross and remove the person from the game. Now, everyone, I request you to stop playing and look at the screen. If possible, you can see how the scores are there. And don't worry about it. It is not just Shaktiman or Ramayan quiz. Biology, mathematics, management, and other subjects which are there, English, grammar, English writing, compositions, reading comprehension, IELTS, TOEFL examination, listening exercises, all these things are there. So here it is, the scoreboard, everyone. The game is going to be stopped and you people will see what it comes. Ending the game, end the game. So the game ended and the results are here. So these are the results. I'm taking a screenshot also. And what I'll do, I'll simply go to this, our WhatsApp group. I'll post it to you. You can see that it looks good. So this is what, now look at the screen that I'm displaying. All the class accuracy 52%. Toughest question was listen and select, because you might not be, you're not that skilled or that quick to navigate between the options, but now you have got to know there is a possibility that there is an audio. So you'll see the toughest question was listen and select this thing. 31 out of 52 players went wrong. Longest question was what do you remember. Now the question is, what do you remember about Dr. Jekyll? Write a few words. Open-ended question, not for marks. Now, on this question, accuracy is 73% and 17 seconds were taken. Means you took more time in it. Interesting fact is, in this thing, interesting facts are that three questions had an accuracy of less than 40%. So that it means we need to find out why these three questions went difficult. Select the characters. For Ramayana, 27 correct, 14 incorrect. Ram, Kapala, Ravan, and Durandar Singh. If you remember Durandar, find out who Durandar was, those who watched Shaktiman. Now, identify this person. 5 people went incorrect and 34 were correct. So, this person is Ravan. And then there is a poll. There was a question of checkbox also, in which you could select multiple, you say, options. Like, see the image and select the correct order. Now, this question is like you can select multiple. So if you have selected multiple, even then it went wrong for you, because you were not required to select multiple. I'm exiting now. Please look at the screen of the presenter. You can see I'm going to reports. Sir, is it visible? Going fine,
visible.
Okay, now what we have done is we have played the game, and the game is like we played it here. There were 52 participants and it completed 12 minutes ago, and since then I have been speaking. So I'm opening the interface. You can see how the report is generated. Can you see this? Shubhamji did one attempt. All these people did one attempt only. If these have been two attempts, so I would have got here two attempts done. Now, players are these. It is showing me the best attempts because there was only one attempt, so it is giving me the best. Sort by score, I can take a printout of the performance of everyone. I can take the printout of the questions, the summary. I can download it as an Excel sheet. You call it a spreadsheet that way. So it is being downloaded, and I can display it to you later, because I need to toggle between the, you say, applications. Now, this is what it is. Suppose the live dashboard is required to be displayed again. So I go to live dashboard and I can show this thing to them again. The same prize distribution and the celebration will be happening. So here we are looking at the same thing. Certain times internet is there, technology is there. So my fellow teachers, the moment you are going to question technology, I will ask you to look at the COVID outbreak and see, can you question science and medical science and doctors and engineers? No, we know the people are doing their best. So that way, if sometimes technology is going to ditch you, sometimes the signal goes away, sometimes the firewall stops the quizzes app or some other thing is there, be patient. Life is all about learning again and again. Now see, it got disconnected again. Now what I'm going to do, we can refresh it later. And that's an internet speed issue. Now this is the report. Now, what I'm doing, I'm going to show you what kind of quizzes are there. Suppose I say MATHS, mathematics. I click on mathematics, also I say maths, and these are the quizzes which are coming, you can see. But you say ye to kuch bhi nahi hai. These are easy ones, say mathematics. The question is, what does DP stands for? Decimal percentages, decimal places, divide people, and dead pigeon. Can somebody post it in the chat? What is the answer to this question? What does DP stands for? What is DP in mathematics? Okay, decimal places, you are right. Okay, fine. This is one thing. Now what I'm going to do, let me go by the grades. I'm taking the university level mathematics. Let me see if there are certain quizzes. No, there are no quizzes for my subject because I didn't decide the subject. I'm going with mathematics here. And let me see, do they have? No, they don't have a university level, high school. It does not mean that there is no resource on the quizzes application. Please remember, you liked the application when you saw the interface. It is an open opportunity for you that because there are no quizzes for mathematics for higher education, you can prepare them. See the bright side of it. There's nothing dark in it. Now, these are the things. This is about the filters. As you learned yesterday, how to search things on YouTube and apply the filters also on Google Images. The most relevant quizzes, most played quizzes. High school, suppose I'm going to middle school mathematics, so it gives me the middle school mathematics topics. Suppose I don't want to do this thing, I'll say CHEMISTRY. Let me go to chemistry, because our science teachers generally have got more doubts on technology because we believe that it may not allow us. Now see, I'm opening just the first one for you, and let me open these things in front of you. Now see, what is an atom? Question. Now protons are these, neutrons are these, electrons are these, atomic number are these, mass number is this. This is because I have not played this game. What I do need to do is I'll click on play live. I'll do these settings, like student attempts unlimited, I'll say only one. It means the student has to log in. I'll say show answers in the game. I will say only validate, only tell them right and wrong, do not tell them the correct answer. Show answers post game after the quiz is over. Can they see the answers? I'll say okay, fine, show them. Now power ups are allowed. You have got lifelines. I'll say no, it's not for fun. Today we are doing it seriously. Timer to be stopped, you can stop it. Leaderboard to be shown to the students, I'll say no, I will declare the leaderboard. shuffle the questions, shuffle the answers. Should I give them a redemption question? Means out of 10 questions, you did 3 questions wrong. So at the end, again, it gives you a redemption question where you can reattempt something. Now this, show the memes. No, we'll stop it and then continue. You click on continue and then a code will appear. You give this code. Suppose this is the code. Now it goes to the chat. And the moment we'll get 5 participants, we'll play it. Only 5 participants allowed. Please do remember it was for science. So people from other domains should try. You need to log in now. You do remember that I had asked you to install it. And some people might have made an account. So Krishna Kumar ji has joined. I'm just waiting for. Good. Rashika Singh Rai has joined. So 2 participants are there. Okay, jumping to 3. 4. And the 5th. Okay, because we can make it a top. Fine, started. You can join late also, please remember. And if I feel that someone should be removed from the quiz, I can simply go click on this cross. Deepak Kumarji, Dr. Mishra, you have joined, but you have joined late. So what I'm going to do, I'm removing it. Please don't mind, you can join again. I'm just demonstrating that people can be removed also during the quiz. If you see someone cheating, it is very tough to go to them and ask for the answer sheet that they have. It is better to remove them from the quiz. Shubham Agarwalji, you have joined, but you are the winner of the previous quiz. So you are removed. So these are the people who are playing the game. Show top 5. I'm just looking at the top 5 now. Even if there are 100 participants, it is just going to show me 5 participants. But still the ranks are 1, 2 and 3. Or the 4 also. Good. Deepak Kumarji, you haven't started playing. Fine, I'm ending the game. See, the winners are here. This is the result. I ended the game and these are the people. There is a possibility that I can click here. I can click on the name of anyone and the report will go to the parents. Suppose I click on Deepak Kumarji's report. No, he hasn't played it. So let's click on the winner. Amit Singh. So what I do is it asks me to share the progress with Amit Singh's parents. So I enter the email ID here and hi there. Today we used quizzes to review chemistry and your child's progress is click below. We can add on something and this is where it goes. I'm just sending it to myself so that if it comes to me on time and then I'll share it with you also. So this is one. I can add more students here so that I can send it to more people. The email has been sent and let's see whether it will be jumping to the inbox. It does. So I'm again coming back to quizzes. Now this is the application. Now in the chat, please share, do you want to know the making of quizzes on it? Because that will be very quick journey. Or we'll move on to another thing. It's for science and non-sciences, and wherever you feel that if the resources are not there, like if you see that you do not find the quiz of your subject, don't crib, make a quiz. It means there is a need for you. Psychology, social science, okay, fine, don't challenge the world. 50% of the schools in US, United States of America, they use this application. It is made by people who are Indians. There are 2 offices, one is in Bangalore and one is in the US. So we have got psychology, grade is 9 to 12, whosoever asked for it. Here it is, I have opened the quiz. What I can do, I can simply go to share with instructors. I'll say I will not be sending you an email. I'm copying the URL. The URL is copied. I'm moving on to our chat. Whosoever asked for psychology, here is the quiz link for you. Why it need code always? Dr. Smita Singh? Because Code is required only when you are going to play live. Now see, this is the quiz that I have opened. If I want to play it live, of course, I have to give the code to someone. After all, you give a question paper to your students when their people appear in the examination. You do give them a proper paper, only then they appear. So you click on play live. When you click on play live, it gives you the option, and the option that it gives you is to play. So the option it gives you is to play as a team when you are going to work through this thing. It means you can make six teams. You'll say, no, I'll make only four teams in my class. Name factory, you want quizzes to generate the names. I'll say very good, because it is going to give very interesting, funny, entertaining names, good names like sleeping sloths, crazy tigers type of thing. So shuffle questions, shuffle answers, these things anybody who is going to get into the interface will understand. And you say continue. When now, see, I have clicked on team. Students answer at their own pace, but their scores are grouped by team. Suppose I'm a bad player in psychology and you are a good player. Doesn't matter, we are a team. Nobody will get to know. Now this is classic. This is test. Test is something in which you simply send them the code and they appear in the test. That is something in which the live scoreboard will not be there, the way you take a class test in the class. So classic, test, and team. I can show you the team thing. And we are just demonstrating things very quickly. The code is 643280. Anybody can join. 643280. You will see that by default, people will get divided into teams. The code is 643280. So the codes are vegan sharks, morning owls, woke sloths, and dancing slugs. So when you are joining, you people are going to get into different teams. See. Your names are also given to you. Your original names are not there. It means I cannot blame that Mr. Deepak, you made us lose, or somebody is not going to get special credit. Everybody is going to get names. But the report will have the original names. Please don't worry about it. And it is very good for your assessment also, because that helps a lot. So now this is how it works. And if I click here, it is almost the same thing. Suppose I'm starting. Okay, Royal Rap, Shubham Mishra. No. Save time. So morning owls, they are the winners, and my report will have, please see, my report will have that the thing that I have, it has gotten the names of students. I will be getting the names in the report, whosoever is what. I can send them the email also. So this is about quizzes. Now this is also, I'm just sharing with you another thing, which is the prize distribution, or how the things have come, so that you people know who won. Now if there is any, like, you can make quizzes, and how you can make quizzes is you simply go to create a quiz, and then it will give you the option of selecting a name for the quiz. You will select a name, you will select the subjects and the grades, and you go and then you add questions. Now suppose I'll say test quiz, I'll say anything. At present, I'm just selecting the random selections for the subjects. And this is the test quiz. It is possible for all of you to rename it, add an image to it, make it public or private. I'm just making it private because it is not a quiz which I want to be public on quizzes. Multiple choice questions, check boxes, fill in the blanks, poll and open-ended. Poll and open-ended, if you give such questions, they do not count for scores. Now, you can do this thing. You can easily make these things because you have been doing it. The special feature is teleport. Now teleport is, I'm making a quiz and I want questions from others. So I'm making a quiz on ENGLISH, English, GRAMMARPREPOSITION. I'm making a quiz on grammar, English grammar, preposition. So what I did, I clicked on teleport. It has opened the quizzes already made by others. Now these are the quizzes and these are the questions. When I click here, the questions get opened here. So if I want to add this question, I click on add and it goes to my basket. See, these are going to my basket. Now what I'm doing, I'm opening random quizzes and I'll say this question looks good, this question looks fine. So what I do, I simply add it. Now please remember, if I'm like you, you can see this thing, this question I have added. And once a question has been added, it will ask you to add it again. It means you cannot double add them. And see, when I come back to my quiz, all the questions that I had teleported have come here. I'll say done. Then language, grades, I'll say grade 2 to grade 5. Suppose private hai, not a problem. I'll save it. I'll finish it. And here is the quiz that I made. I'll click on play live. And then you have seen this interface. Two more things I want to tell you. Assign homework. You click on assign homework. You give them a deadline. Suppose I give you 27, this and this. You click on continue. You get a code. You give them the code. The code is for homework only. And another one, just to like make a quick journey. This is reports. Now, you can you see something green? All these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This test quiz, because I gave you it as an assignment. I'm deleting it so that you don't see a fake report. Now, these green things are the homework I assigned to my classes. I've been using this resource only because of that thing I'm sharing it with you. 16 people have done, 13 people have done. This is the report and this is assigned. And this quiz still has a date. They have 26th and 27th. But still, I can end it. If I click here, I can end the game. Otherwise, the quiz is still there. It is due and the people can do. Now, these are my students who have done this quiz. I can send them their report. I can print it. I can export it. So all these things happen. I can take a printout. You can see beautiful things come. And these are the things. So this can be done. And one more thing. Now, suppose I have made a quiz and I do not, my university says we don't have internet. So what you do, you bring a printout of it. So how do I get a printout? Now this is the report generation. Now you can see I am getting the report of all the students. All the questions are there with me. So this is LKMS test review, 64% accuracy. This is the report which is designed by quizzes. Now this is the quiz that you people have played. I want to take a printout of it. I click on printout and you see a very nice quiz comes to you. You can see this. This is the quiz in printout. I can take a print of it and I can play. I can give the answer key appear on the next page when you take a printout. When you take the printout, the answer key doesn't appear. It appears only on that. And now this is good for the assessment that you people do in the universities. The people have made content for schools also, but you people can do wonders. Now this is one thing. Another thing that I wanted to tell you is related, that is related to something which is, you hear it first. And if the audio doesn't come, please do let me know.
जो पढ़ नहीं सकते, उन्हें अनपढ़ कहकर हम ऐसे लोगों के लिए कोई शब्द नहीं छोड़ते जो पढ़ सकते हैं मगर पढ़ते नहीं. उनसे भी बड़ी संख्या में वे लोग हैं जो पढ़ते हैं पर समझते नहीं. यदि कोई आपसे पूछे कि पढ़ने का उद्देश्य क्या है, तो फौरन कोई उत्तर देना आसान नहीं होगा. पढ़ना हम सब ने, यानी मैंने भी, आपने भी, इतना पहले सीखा था कि अब जीवन के उस दौर की चर्चा करना कुछ अटपटा लगेगा. शायद व्यर्थ भी होगा, क्योंकि उस समय पढ़ना इसलिए सीख रहे थे कि कोई सिखा रहा था.
दिस इज वन एंड देन देयर आर डिफरेंट थिंग्स लाइक दिस इज समथिंग अबाउट रिज्यूमे.
हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रवीण.
Now then you can click on like, and all these things are there. Like I might not be considered a sir said it because of that thing. Now it is podcasting that we are talking about. Your audios go live. So this is the thing that I can share with you.
Computer or iPad.
We made this episode when I was working with the community radio at MIT University. So this is the episode we did on International Book Fair. So and these are the the things you can see, these are the audios of the stories that my students had. So the students recorded, and the same recordings were being placed here, and we named it learningradio.podbean.com. I'll tell you the limitations also about free and paid.
A Cup of Tea by Catherine Mansfield. Rosemary Fell was not exactly beautiful.
And this girl was doing her MBBS internship. She did not have anything to do with this syllabus also. But still, she recorded it, and it is there in our database also. Now this girl, Babus of Nayanjore's narration was done by the class student herself. The editing was done by me on Audacity. I did the editing though, but still, like, this is our radio podcasting channel. The story is Babus of Nayanjore by Rabindranath Tagore, and that is why the music.
I'm Malika Gulati, a student of Maharishi Markandeshwar Institute of Physiotherapy and Rehabilitation, an institute under Maharishi Markandeshwar deemed to be university.
One more thing, like, this is something you people will like. Personally, like, we like this thing and it feels good. I'm just sharing this thing with you. And all this is going to the creative, you say, domain.
The Babus of Nayanjore.
Okay, now this is quizzes. Quizzes is free. 500 users at a time can play. 500 users on quizzes can play, so that is quizzes. I'll be sharing with you a presentation on how to use the quizzes thing. And in the university's assessment system, where online assessment is required, quizzes can play a vital role. Now, when we are talking about Podbean, so Podbean is something in which you can record your audios. I'll be demonstrating to you through the mobile phone in a short while how we do it, or some of you can also work on it if you people want. Podbean will be working in a short while. Now, if there are queries like about what we have done is we have done podcasting, so podcast podcasting via podbean. Some of you might be curious to use the interface yourself. So before that thing, before like I bring to you my mobile screen, I'm requesting you all to prepare a quiz on quizzes, and it should be prepared only by those who are using a laptop. If you're using a laptop, prepare. If you are using a laptop, prepare a short quiz on quizzes so that you can share your screen and show us that you have made a quiz.
So friends, I hope you have understood. Dr. Parveen is saying that quickly when he is demonstrating this, we give you around say a few minutes. You can quickly make a short quiz of around 5 questions, not more than that. And let us know in the chat box here, then we can use teleport. In that case, you can quickly and try to see to include general questions, because we can then play it here so that all you can participate, and we will give you the chance whose quiz is ready so that you can see that how you can administer that and others can play. So till Dr. Parveen explains you, in the meantime, just go ahead.
And if you people,
yeah, this is an important question, Satish ji, but Dr. Parveen would like to explain it about equations.
Yes sir, let's like explain it first so that we have got that thing. We are moving on to quizzes, and we are going to just check it out whether we can insert the equations or not. Now please, like, pardon me for that thing that I don't know equations, but I do what do you say identify what mathematics is. I'm just going to the same quiz, test quiz, which is private. This is the test quiz. I'm clicking on edit. You can make any quiz made by others your own just by clicking on edit. The moment you click on edit, change the name, change the photo, change the grades and everything, change a few questions, and then you save, it becomes yours. Now I'm clicking on a new question. I'm going to the chat if my one of my friend has said something. Sir, you will be like, I know, once you see it, you will be able to make it yourself. Now this is the question, sir. In making the questions, I can add a media. I click here, I can record an audio, suppose, or I can upload it. Suppose this is the thing about which subject the question has been asked. Stopped. Save. You are talking about maths. You are talking about English. Or you are talking about Hindi. You are talking about social science. So that audio has come here. Listen to, I'm just sharing before I take you to the equation thing. This is the question. I'm saving the question. Okay, which is the correct one? This is the correct one. Time given 30 seconds. I'll say no, we can give them 45. You can set the time. You can add image to every this thing, every question. Now, one more question, sir. Multiple choice, sir. I'm going to mathematics now. The moment I clicked it, now I guess you must be happy. Now let me do it the way I can want to do it. And don't mind. Yes, sir. Can you see this thing? Good. No. Okay, okay. Or something like, you can add anything. You can give the answers. You can put whole equations. I go here. And Greek, advanced, all these things are there. You can do it. You will be selecting them. And after that, what you will be doing, you will be just inserting them. Here it is, sir. I guess this clarifies, like, yes. It's not just a small tool. It is something like, you people are going to enjoy it. This is what is the minimum we can say. So if there is any other thing, it has fill equation thing. Quizzes is free, everyone. Podbean. Now Podbean has got a limitation on the duration. I guess 5 hours they people used to give. You can upload maximum of 5 hours to it. Usse zyada nahi. Beyond that, the people charge. So the money thing does come. So please understand this thing. This is quizzes. If there is any more query, 5 hours on Podbean are required. If I can demonstrate the Podbean thing to you, I'll just do it to you. Now you which is the what screen you people see? Is it, sir, only the quizzes, the Google Chrome?
No, we see the quizzes in which recommended for you. What will you teach today? The
yes,
homepage
yes.
of quizzes.
Only quizzes is there. Like it did not switch to any other thing. Suppose I tried to open a presentation that did not come, I guess.
No, you have to share again.
Okay, sir. What I'm doing is...
Otherwise, you can open a new tab here and then that can come.
I'm just opening Podbean and we are demonstrating to them the interface which is here, so that once I switch on to mobile phone, I won't like come back to this again. Now see, this is the Podbean dashboard on the laptop. Everyone, please remember, mobile phones are mobile phones and desktops are desktops. That's the minimum, like, you people can use to differentiate. The things you can do on a desktop cannot be done on a mobile phone. Mobile phones are just required to be used when required. Otherwise, the basic interfaces of all these platforms are designed for desktop versions. Now, this is the Learning Radio's site. You can see this thing here. I can go to the profile and all these things. I have made an account on this. What I'm doing, I'm just going to my dashboard. And when the dashboard will open, you will see, I'll just log in. So here is the dashboard, everyone. Just because you people have listened to this channel, so it says 700 all time. This is the channel on which the same notes were there. It's 27 rise and something something. So what I do, I go to the channel itself. I click here. So this is here it opens. I'm going to publish now. For the publishing, suppose you record an audio on your mobile phone. One, you use Audacity to edit it. Step number two. You make an MP3 of it and then you simply upload it here, new episode, and then you upload, you give all the details. Now, I have got only 13 minutes left, as you can see. Otherwise, I need to upgrade it. So click a file and you upload everything and it comes to you and then you publish it. This is the thing you do from Learning Radio channels like Podbean's interface. And this is one. If you see, I can show you, sir had mentioned Eklavya. So this is his Podbean channel. Like he has got 13 episodes and around 269 things. So these are different episodes which are there. So your students can be asked to submit like these things. This is the one of the episodes.
मेरा नाम एकलव्य है और मैं क्लास KG2 में पढ़ता हूँ। आज आपको मैं बहुत सारी बातें बताऊंगा।
And his friend came to play, so the children were playing at home. And then
मेरा नाम एकलव्य है। आज मैं आपको दिवांगी से मिलवाऊंगा मेरी
So interesting thing is, this was December 12, and the one now you are listening to is December 15.
Friend. और आपको मैं मिलाता ही रहूँगा, एक इंटरव्यू करूँगा मैं.
So this is one thing, and then there are so many things like this one also. We are just like telling them the thing.
Om, Bol, Papa, Sa, Tachi.
So these are the things like we have cricket and he sang a song and then we recorded it. He recorded it. So this is how it goes. He went to the local radio station also, All India Radio, Rukshetra FM. So he recorded an episode there also, which is also being placed here. Like he went to radio station, he told us that what is there, what are the feelings, and then we got that episode from the radio station, recorded it, and then we also placed that episode here. So this is his channel. So every teacher who is listening to me, you can also make your own these things. Podbean is an audio telecast site. Everybody of you cannot make YouTube videos, you will agree to it, but you have got words to speak. You are sending these words either by WhatsApp audios or you are not doing like anything. So this is there. Now if you want me to like work on this thing, like some new episodes and something, let's go to the mobile phone site. And if there is any query regarding this thing, you can please post it in the chat. Meanwhile, I'm just clicking on the join link and then joining the meeting on the mobile phone. One more thing I wanted to show. I kept it, I guess it is somewhere. YouTube. Yes. Sir, I just want to show the Podbean, Powtoon thing that we had made. Just to show that.
Yes.
See.
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. Now, the thing is, every one of you, forget about the PowerPoint presentations. The world has moved beyond it. There's a resource that, sir, like, shares, AnyMaker. So Powtoon is a junior version of it with certain limitations of money also. But you can see this thing, which was made on Powtoon. And this is about the 7 steps of making a presentation. Here it is.